To this current affair topic, that is genetically modified crops. In this lecture we will see how these genetically modified crops are beneficial for the farmers and in what manner they are against the ecological balance of the environment. How these crops are produced, in what manner these crops are produced, and why these crops are produced. Moving ahead with this lecture, so what exactly is genetically modified crops? So in the layman term, if I want to explain, so the example will be like, we will extract some features from a particular bacteria or a microorganism and we give this feature to this plant. Okay, in the layman term this is the example that how this GM crops getting developed. So what happened? First we identify a particular gene in this bacteria. First we will identify the particular genes in this bacteria which is resistant to a particular environment or particular weather conditions or even that another pest and all. And after that going research on those genes and the requirement, we will implant these genes to the synthesized nucleic acid of the plant seeds, and after that we will grow that seed, and that seeds will be called, that seed will be called as a genetically modified crops. Now what will happen when this crop will grow? Ultimately this will be also acting as a same resistant to the particular environment from that, similarly like that bacteria from which that gene was taken. Okay, so this is the overview of that genetically modified crops production. How is it getting formed? Okay, so these crops get engineered genetically, that is their genes have been altered in order to provide a certain tolerant providers. How? So a particular gene is getting identified from the required bacteria or the microorganism, then we copied it to synthesize for the nucleic acid of the plant. Okay, this was the basic definitions, basic process for the production of the GM crops. Okay, so what will happen when these crops are getting produced? This crop will what become resistant to a particular pest, particular weather conditions and all. Similarly in India, BT cotton is allowed in the production as a GM crops, and in the year ultimately it was seen that the BT cotton was attacked by pest, bollworm kind of pest in the cotton, and after the production of this BT cotton we saw that the production of this was increased at a very high rate, and it was the result of these modified crops. But after a period of time we have seen that pest, that pink bollworm, this pink bollworm has been modified too. And after the modification of the after the evolution of this pink bollworm, now this BT cotton is proved to be useless. See, this is the scenario, this is the point of worry for the genetically modified crops that have been seen. So what is the issue? Well, let us see in the slide what I have written, then we will move to the another slide and we will explain you much better. Okay, so these genetically modified crops will give resistance to the pest, dry conditions, and India cotton is generally grown in the rain fed areas. Agriculture is totally dependent on rain only, so no method of irrigation. So farmer faced lots of destruction for cotton crop due to lack of rain or pest attacks. Okay, so BT cotton get derived from the genetically modified crops and was cure regarding the pest name, that is a pink bollworm. And upon introduction of this BT cotton, productivity and efficiency was increased because we engineered on that seed of that BT cotton, and ultimately that seed was resistant to the pink bollworm. And ultimately what happened, that the pesticide used by the farmers too was not required for the production of that BT cotton. See, earlier it was like that when the cotton was being agricultured, then pesticide was required by the farmers on that cotton to keep away this pink worm kind of pest. But when this BT cotton was introduced, there was no need for pesticide. Ultimately, the cost of the production of the cotton was also reduced, and the quantity of the cotton production was increased. So from the both side, farmer was getting benefit at a high rate. Okay, so like the now the crop, like the crop could take care of itself. 2002 to 2003, if we see the data, that it was produced 191 kg per hectare, and in the cotton is calculated in the term of bales, so it was 8.62 million bales. And after introduction of 2017 to 18, it was 427 kg per hectare, and that is 34.89 million bales. So it was around more than four times we are getting production, and the the cost for the pesticide was also not was saved by the farmer. So it was a win-win situation for the farmer. Okay, so this GM crop was proved by this slide. As per this information, it is good, but the issue is like when this GM crop is introduced, your pest will also try to evolve. See what happened, that when the medicines for malaria was developed, it was A. I'm giving just example that medicine was A. After that, what happened? Mosquitoes also get evolved. And as the mosquitoes get evolved, that medicine A produced became useless. Then again, we have to get research and all, we started to produce A plus medicine. Then again, we kept away that type of we used to cure malaria from the A plus medicines. Now again, what happened? Mosquitoes will again evolve, and again you have to make some different medicines and all. So what happened? We are actually disturbing the ecological balance of the nature. This is the main issue. We are disturbing the balance of the nature, because ultimately your pest will also evolve as per the requirement. And one more thing, like when you are introducing GM crop, like suppose there is a farmer A and there is farmer B, and both have a land near to it. Farmer A used GM crops and farmer B used normal crops. Okay, so what happened when the GM crop is being introduced? He will get too much production, he will get good production in the land, but ultimately what happened, because of that GM crop effect, the pest will attack too much on these normal crops, and ultimately his crop will be hampered. And one more thing, like see, with respect to vaccine, like right now this video is being prepared in a corona time where there is no vaccine. Okay, so right now see, when the corona vaccine, let us example any a virus vaccine is getting prepared. Okay, so what happened, the items, the chemicals, the medicines that will be used in the preparation of vaccine may be, suppose let us suppose rupees 100. Okay, but what happened in the production of this vaccine, lots of research was taken place, the salaries of those employees, and during the research also many research got failed. So ultimately what happened, that company will impose all the price, all the failure of the research price, all the success of the research price, all the employee salaries and all, they will try to collect with the selling of the vaccine. And ultimately this actual cost of the vaccine as per the material used in the production of that vaccine, this cost will jump up to 1,000, 1,500 or 2,000. Okay, so the investment that was done, they will try to recover it. So similarly, when this GM crops will get formed, in normal situation the private company will do all the research and all. If the government will do, then it is okay, no issue. Government can regulate the price and all. Currently government used to regulate the price of pesticide and all in the agriculture. Okay, so The farmers had a fear that when these genetically modified crops will be produced, ultimately the privatization will come under the farming. Like these seeds will be getting produced by those private players. They will start imposing all the tax and all, and after that the price of the seed will increase. Like now the kind of cost in the pesticide was they were giving, ultimately now they have to pay high price for the seeds. So that was the point of worry for the farmers, and ultimately that the GM crops production and the research was banned by the Supreme Court by the protest of the farmers. So what is in this slide, we will see just it in overview. So first, genetically modified crops across the world was nothing but tomato, where the flavor, like the when the tomato was getting old, then maybe some flavors are getting changed. So it was modified as that the flavor will be saved and the shelf life of the tomato will be increased. Okay, because tomato get tomato have a very short life. Similarly, in the brinjal case, brinjal is the crop where too much pest attacks happen. So ultimately, BT brinjal was formed through the genetically modification, and similarly, genetically modification of the mustard was also there. One, the golden rice is there, that is a rich source of vitamin A. This is also a genetically modified crop. So what happened when it comes to India? I'm sorry, I have a cough and all, so you are getting that voice and all, sorry for that. Okay, so when it comes to India, genetically modified crops which is allowed to India is only BT cotton, right? Why? So when the still you will see in the Haryana regions BT cotton is grown is illegally, but it is not legal in India. Why these things happened? What happened? Most farmers tend to indulge in illegally grown crops, the GMOs. Like the reason behind the banning of this crop is like that. In the 2009-11, a genetically engineering appraisal committee GEAC, which comes under the Ministry of Environment, Climate and all, had given approval for growing the BT brinjal. Okay, but public protest came by the certain farmers by supposing that those who will be farming will come under the privatization, that they were by assumption that they took place. And ultimately after that, this matter went to the Supreme Court, and Supreme Court a technical committee was set up within the Supreme Court, and this technical committee gave a report on 2012, as it was started in 2011. So they give a report in 2012 and said immediately ban on the testing and introduction of the GM crops till 2022. This is 2020, the video on which I am making. In 2022 we will see what will happen. So the first concern was environment, like we are damaging the ecological balance of the environment. Okay, we are damaging the ecological balance of the environment. So that was the one main concern given by them. So any GM crops shall be grown in the native variety of the seed right now. So what will happen, like when we are introducing GM crops, the pest will also get evolved, and ultimately this is nothing but we are playing with the environmental issues and all. Ultimately if this get involved, then what will we do? Then we have to again re-engineer and all, and whether we will be able to produce that seed or not, we are not sure. Okay, that's why we have a seed bank and also to preserve the old seeds that we will use in the near future if we require. So native variety will start getting replaced because of one kind of crop will prevail in the market, which is not good for genetic adaptation, biodiversity and ecological balance. And second concern was regarding the private players, as explained earlier. So this dominate the seed market, and ultimately the price of the seed will increase. So evolution of resistant pests will also take place, and we will see that this pink ball worm, this is pink ball worm, has evolved, and now BT cotton is unable to, in many cases BT cotton is unable to resist those evolved pink ball worm. So this is the example, like how this pest will also evolve. Okay, you modified that crop, so pest will also get evolved, and ultimately this will proven to be useless. So what we have to do? We have to do more research and all on those issues, on those evolution, on those modification, and we have to study their positives and negativity. positive and negative aspects of those seeds. And after that, we should have to allow those seeds in the market, because see, we need those seeds too in the market, because India is completely an agrarian country where we need huge production. As per the population, we need huge production. The increasing of the food is in the form of arithmetic product progression, and the population is increasing as a geometric progression. So we have to match that gap between the food production and the population increase. Right now we are controlling the population too, but the kind of population we have, it will take too much time to match with the food production of the country. Okay, that's why we need to introduce GM crops. It is not like that we should not introduce, but it should be done on a very high scale. Like, the research should be done at very high scales, and we have to study all the positives and negative aspects of the seeds. Okay, so GAC that gave the approval for the BT brinjal in the 2011 and 9 and all. So GAC is, that is a body under the Ministry of Environment, Forest and Climate Change, and it is a statutory body. That is nothing but a constitutional body, not a constitutional body, as a statutory body is nothing but that those kind of body that established as an act of law, not by the constitution. So it was established under the Act of 1986, and this committee is involved in giving the approval of that, those GM crops and all that should be, that we should, do we have to give that approval to the GM crops or not, by looking on the all the positives and negative aspects of that too, and by looking on those things, then only we should be give approval for the GM crops, because it is ultimately affecting our ecological balance of the society, of the environment, biodiversity of the environment and all. Okay, so India is an agrarian country where basic production is still stagnant, and many farmers do suicide every year. India is counted in those countries where the lots of the huge number of farmer suicides happen within a year. So due to lack of water, pest and attacks, so that farmers do suicide. So we have to introduce that GM crop, but with the lots of research, and we have to take care for these issues also. So we need more extensive study research at pan India level, and the introduction of the crop should be in phase wise. Why it should be in phase wise? See, let us suppose, like, in the phase wise also the research will take in place. Like, let us suppose we will introduce phase 1. In the phase 1, what will happen? We will see that a land produce 100 kg of rice this year. Okay, good. In the phase 2, we will see this land, like when the introduction of all those things, we have seen that this land grows 150 kg of rice. Okay, again in the phase 3, we may see that the land is produce 125 kg, right? Now this is a point of a study. Why this land again declined in the production of that rice? So the research will take place that whether the pest are getting evolved as per the modification of the crops. So this kind of research will take place during the phase wise introduction of the crop, and this is the benefit of introducing of the phase wise. Even the vaccine, when introduced in the market, it is introduced as a phase wise. Okay, so I hope you understand this lecture. Please like and subscribe the channel. Your subscription is a form of payment for me. If you have any suggestions, if you want any on demand video lecture, please feel free to ping on my Twitter handle. Thank you.